The gingiva, or gums, are the soft tissues providing support and protection to the teeth. They can become inflamed or swollen due to bacterial plaque and poor oral hygiene, leading to a condition known as gingivitis. The primary cause of gingivitis is the accumulation of bacterial plaque on the teeth. This plaque, or biofilm, is a mix of bacteria, food debris, and saliva, which adheres to the tooth surface. When it accumulates, it triggers an immune response in the body, leading to inflammation of the gum tissues. As a result, the gums become swollen or edematous, and red or erythematous. They also become tender and more prone to bleeding, bleeding being a hallmark of gingivitis. Patients may also experience tooth sensitivity and bad breath. Risk factors for gingivitis significantly influences development and progression. These can include poor oral hygiene, such as inadequate brushing and flossing, leading to plaque buildup and gum inflammation. Smoking exacerbates this risk by impairing gum blood flow and weakening the immune response, making gums more prone to infection and inflammation. Age also plays a minor role, where older individuals are often more susceptible to gingivitis due to reduced oral care and natural wear. Hormonal changes during life stages like pregnancy, puberty, or menopause can increase gum sensitivity and susceptibility to gingivitis, as these changes can alter the blood flow to the gums, causing swelling and irritation. Medications, particularly anticonvulsants, calcium channel blockers, and immunosuppressants, may promote gum tissue overgrowth or hyperplasia. They can also alter the saliva flow, thus increasing the risk of gum disease. Additionally, chronic conditions like diabetes and heart disease contribute to gingivitis risk by impacting the immune system and blood circulation. This hinders the body's ability to combat the gingivitis-causing bacteria and impairs gum healing. Gingivitis can be classified into dental biofilm-induced and non-dental biofilm-induced types. The dental biofilm-induced gingivitis is primarily associated with the accumulation of dental plaque due to poor oral hygiene practices. It can also be influenced by various systemic or local factors like smoking, diabetes, medications, or hormonal changes like previously specified. Non-dental biofilm-induced gingivitis encompasses various factors that can lead to gum inflammation, and these can include genetic or developmental disorders, which may predispose individuals to gingival issues, whilst specific infections, including viral or fungal ones, can directly affect gum health. Inflammatory and immune conditions, such as autoimmune diseases, can contribute to chronic gum inflammation. Neoplasia or oral tumors can also impact the gums. Additionally, endocrine disorders like diabetes, nutritional deficiencies, and metabolic diseases are linked to gingival problems. Traumatic injuries to the gums can induce inflammation, and changes in gingival pigmentation may also indicate an underlying health issue, further emphasizing the importance of oral health. Diagnosing gingivitis starts with reviewing the patient's dental and medical histories to identify underlying systemic conditions or past oral hygiene habits. This background information is key to understanding the potential causes and progression of the condition. Following the history, a focused oral examination is performed. Dentists look for signs of gingivitis, like erythema, edema, and bleeding during brushing. Oral health professionals may also probe the area to assess for any bleeding on probing or progression into periodontitis, which will be discussed in another video. Now, gingivitis has a cure and is reversible with proper treatment, and it usually requires no surgical intervention. Non-surgical management includes professional dental debridement to remove the plaque and calculus, as well as instructions to the patient on how to effectively manage oral hygiene. Oral health professionals may also recommend antiseptic mouthwashes to help reduce plaque and gingival inflammation. This is if mechanical means like brushing and flossing are ineffective. Supportive therapy includes lifestyle modifications such as quitting smoking, managing diabetes, or addressing nutritional deficiencies. To summarize, the gingiva provides tooth support but can become inflamed, leading to gingivitis due to bacterial plaque and poor oral hygiene. Risk factors for this include poor oral hygiene, smoking, age, hormonal changes, medications, diabetes, and heart disease. Gingivitis can also be classified based on clinical appearance and etiology, as well as duration. Diagnosis involves reviewing the dental and medical histories, as well as conducting an oral examination. Gingivitis is reversible with non-surgical management, including professional debridement and oral hygiene education, as well as antiseptic mouthwashes where necessary. Supportive therapies include lifestyle changes like smoking cessation and managing the underlying conditions. Surgical intervention is rarely needed for gingivitis.